Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Westside Congregation in Rio Rancho. If you've never visited us before, we extend a special welcome to you now. We hope that when our building is open again for services that you will join us on site. I'm the Reverend Dr. Nancy Hitt, the consulting minister for this congregation. Our speaker this morning is the Reverend Carole Eagleheart. She has some opening words for us today from the poet John O'Donohue.
Awaken to the mystery of being here and enter the quiet immensity of your own presence. Have joy and peace in the temple of your senses. Receive encouragement when new frontiers beckon. Respond to the call of your gift and the courage to follow its path. Let the flame of anger free you of all falsity. May warmth of heart keep your presence aflame. May anxiety never linger about you. May your outward dignity mirror an inner dignity of soul. Take time to celebrate the quiet miracles that seek no attention. Be consoled in the secret symmetry of your soul. May you experience each day as a sacred gift woven around the heart of wonder.
As Unitarian Universalists, we have a set of principles and sources from which we draw. Today, our service is titled Walking as Meditation. It springs from Principle 4, a free and responsible search for truth and meaning. And it is based on Source 1, direct experience of that transcending mystery and wonder affirmed in all cultures, which moves us to a renewal of the spirit and an openness to the forces that create and uphold life. In each of our services, we share announcements that are important to our congregation. This week, we are happy to announce that we have hired a new bookkeeper. We expect that she will soon be working on our books, accessing them remotely from her home in Santa Fe. If you have newspapers for Rio the dog, please drop them off in the bin under the pergola for her. Please be sure to replace the bricks that secure the lid. We do not want to be littering the desert. I am also happy to announce that the small tree that our neighbors complained was blocking the view at the end of Inca Road and was a safety hazard was transplanted last year to an inside corner of our parking lot. It is currently doing well, having leafed out along with the other two trees that it now lives with. And next Sunday, July 5th, our building will be staffed from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. so that you can drop off your Storehouse West donation. Jay and Laurel will be here to receive your donation. You may donate any canned or dry goods. If you'd like some suggestions, the list of what is most needed is in your recent church email. And I know this is a challenge for all of you who like to delete stuff right after you read it. If you need it again, you can email me and I will send it to you. There is no need to disinfect or prepare your donation in any special way. Storehouse West says that they would also love to have your plastic grocery bags, and if you receive a newspaper, they'd also like the plastic bag that your newspaper sometimes comes in. Apparently, that holds exactly one bar of soap and one roll of toilet paper, and they're making excellent use recycling those bags in that way. We ask, too, that you please wear a mask when you make your donation. Thank you. Each week we include in our service a reminder of the animals who share our planet with us. Here is Bramcast Hecht with our Animal Ministry Moment.
Don't forget to treat yourself. Take time to appreciate yourself. A little care and meditation for the inner you can only make you better. Take pride in yourself and honor the positives. And this is a little dog. And he says, Stick, mysterious and woody, how I love thee, so loyal and true. Why do I crave you so? Never would I let you go. Hark! What's that lying in yonder trees? Another stick? Stick, mysterious and woody, how I love thee.
It is time for the lighting of our chalice. If you have a personal candle or chalice with you at home, draw it closer to you now. Let us read the chalice lighting words together. We light our chalice as a symbol of that inner light which we can kindle and share with the world. Please join me now in affirming our aspirations. Life is a gift. We gather in community to celebrate the glories and the mysteries of this great gift. In the light of truth and in the warmth of love, we gather to seek, to sustain, and to share. Love is the doctrine of this congregation. The quest for truth is our sacrament, and service is our prayer. To dwell together in peace, to seek knowledge in freedom, to serve others in community, to the end that all souls grow into harmony with creation. Thus do we covenant with one another. Carol will now lead us in a moment for centering.
This is a time to pause and let go of any distracting thoughts. Become aware of your body. No judgment, just awareness. Become aware of your hands. What position are they in? Are they open? Are they closed? Become aware of your feet and your legs. And focus for a moment on your breathing. Breathing in, breathing out. Become aware of your chest rising and falling with each breath. And as you breathe, let go of any tension you may be feeling in your body. Breathe and find your center, the quiet place deep within you, the place of inner knowing, the place of ease and balance. Breathe and be at peace.
It is our tradition in each service to share the personal joys and concerns of our congregation. This week we rejoice that we have hired a new bookkeeper for our congregation. She will soon begin working from home to do our bookkeeping. Stacy is back at work with Christian and his new baby brother Alex and having a wonderful time. Jamie reports that the checkup on her broken bones shows that they are healing well. We hope for freedom from pain and speedy healing for her. Jimmy also reports that he is doing better. It's been several weeks since he's fallen. He's working closely with his healthcare team to figure out what's going on and to respond appropriately to it. Robert and Bobby continue to do well at their respective long-term care facilities. If you would like to send either of them a card, please email me and I can forward their address to you. In addition to our personal joys and concerns, we continue to hold the state of our world close to our hearts. We hold deep concern for all that is confusing and contrary and wrong. We hold joy for all of the initiatives and responses in which we see the best of humanity at work. For the political machinations that are in play, for the international pressures and power-seeking maneuvers, we hold concern. For the voices around the world that call for an end to racist attitudes and practices, we hold joy. For the continuing oppression and victimization of people of color, we grieve with deep concern. For the victims of racial violence of any sort, we light this red candle. Shalom. Each week we give and receive an offering of our gifts of love and commitment. Your gifts are important because our expenses continue even when we are not gathering together on site. Thank you for continuing to support this congregation.
Before the pandemic, how active were you? I used to go to water aerobics 3 or 4 days a week and to do silver sneakers classes twice a week, but not anymore. They stopped holding those classes to prevent the spread of the virus. I don't know about you, but my main form of exercise right now is walking. Walking is good for us. For one thing, it strengthens our hearts. We're told that walking at least 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week, can reduce our risk for coronary heart disease by about 19%. Walking can burn calories. I really like that part. And it strengthens our bones and muscles. It actually eases joint pain by lubricating and strengthening the muscles that support our joints. Walking can boost our immune functions. That's a really important consideration right now. Before the current pandemic, there was one study that tracked 1,000 adults during flu season. Those who walked at a moderate pace, 30 to 45 minutes a day, had 43% fewer sick days and fewer upper respiratory tract infections. Now, that's an inspiration to get you off the couch, isn't it? Walking can boost our energy even more effectively than grabbing a cup of coffee. It increases oxygen flow through the body. It can also increase levels of hormones that help elevate our energy levels. Walking can improve our mood, and it can help clear our heads and help us to think more creatively. There was a study about which made it easier to think creatively, sitting or walking. They compared people trying to think of new ideas and tested them when they were sitting and when they were walking. The researchers found that people did better at the creative thinking while they were walking, especially when they were walking outdoors. But today, I want to talk about walking from a spiritual perspective, walking as a form of meditation. For inspiration, I turn to the Buddhist monk and peace activist Thich Nhat Hanh. Thich Nhat Hanh says, many of us walk for the sole purpose of getting from one place to another. Now, suppose we're walking to a sacred place. We would walk quietly and take each gentle step with reverence. He says, I propose that we walk this way every time we walk on the earth. The earth is sacred, and we touch her with each step. We should be very respectful because we're walking on our mother. If we walk like that, then every step will be grounding. Every step will be nourishing. Hanh says, we can train ourselves to walk with reverence. Wherever we walk, whether it's to the railway station or the supermarket, we're walking on the earth, and so we're in a holy sanctuary. If we remember to walk like that, we can be nourished and find solidity in each step. So how do we do this? He has some suggestions for us. He says we have to notice each step. Each step made in mindfulness can bring us back to the here and the now. Go slowly, he says. Mindfulness lights our way. We don't rush. With each breath, we may take just one step. Han says we may have run all our life, but we don't have to run anymore. This is the time to stop running. To be grounded in the earth is to feel its solidity with each step and know that we are right where we're supposed to be. He tells us that each mindful breath, each mindful step reminds us that we're alive on this beautiful planet. We don't need anything else. It is wonderful enough just to be alive, to breathe in, and to make one step. We've arrived at where real life is available, the present moment. If we breathe and walk this way, he said, we become as solid as a mountain. Han says there are those of us who have a comfortable house, but we don't feel like we're at home. We don't want for anything, and yet we don't feel home. All of us are looking for our solid ground, our true home. He says the earth is our true home, and it's always there beneath us and around us. Breathe, take a mindful step, and arrive. We are already at home. So what if our mind is buzzing and we start worrying or thinking about something else? Han says we can't be grounded in our body if our mind is somewhere else. We each have a body that's been given us by the earth. This body is a wonder. In our daily lives, he says, we may spend many hours forgetting the body. We get lost in our computer or in our worries, fear, or busyness. Walking meditation makes us whole again. Only when we're connected with our body are we truly alive. So walk and breathe in such a way that you can connect with your body deeply. Now, maybe your physical health won't allow you to walk right now, but I hope these thoughts will inspire you in your sitting meditation. We can always listen to our bodies and adapt the ideas to what we're physically able to do. Thinking about what Thich Nhat Hanh says, I began exploring various walks around Rio Rancho and Albuquerque. It helps to begin practicing walking meditation in a place that's quiet, a place where you're not being jostled and distracted by other people around you. It's also helpful to try walking meditation in a place that's level, where walking is easy and you're not having to strain at going uphill or managing difficult terrain. So I decided to seek out these places, not just for my own meditation, but to share with you. And when I found a good place to practice walking meditation, I brought my GoPro camera and began to shoot video to give you a feel of what it could be like on that particular walk. So I'm going to show you some of those places right now. Don't worry about how to get to them because I'm including very detailed directions in an email. The first very special place that I want to show you is a walk that I've done many times in the past. The North Valley of Albuquerque is crisscrossed by many little irrigation channels called acequias. I've explored many of them. This is one of my favorites. It's off of Rio Grande, just below Paseo del Norte. And one of the reasons it's a favorite of mine is that you get to walk by the running water and see beautiful roses along the way. So here's the first video. May it be a meditation for you. As you walk in meditation, pay attention to everything around you, to the flow of the water, to the tiny ant on the bark of a tree, to the petals of flowers. Become aware of the breeze touching your face and stirring the leaves of the trees. Become aware of your whole body. Thich Nhat Hanh says one way to start walking meditation is to become aware of your breath. He says, walking meditation unites our body and our mind. We combine our breathing with our steps. When we breathe in, we may take 2 or 3 steps. When we breathe out, we may take 3, 4, or even 5 steps. We pay attention to what is comfortable for our body. He says, our breathing has the function of helping our body and our mind to calm down. As we walk, we can say, breathing in, I calm my body. Breathing out, I bring peace into my body. Hanh says calming the breath calms the body and reduces any pain and tension. When we walk like this with our breath, we bring our body and our mind back together. Our body and our mind are 2 aspects of the same reality. Now, when I searched for walks in this area that would help me with walking meditation, I found one that I'd never been on before. It's called Willow Creek Trail. It's here in Rio Rancho, not far from where Adalia Road crosses Route 528. Now, the wonderful thing about this place is that it leads you by level trails to the river. You don't have to clamber up and down steep banks. The Rio Grande is an amazing stretch of water, and walking by the river can be a spiritual experience. In this video, I've tried to give you a feel of what it's like being by the river, and I've included two poems that are meaningful to me.
The poet Linda Hogan says, "The river doesn't remember the womb of its beginning. It doesn't look back to where it's been, or wonder who ahead of it polished the rough stones. It is following the way in its fullness, now like satin, now cresting, waters meeting, kindred to travel gathered together, all knowing it flows one way, shining or in shadows." Poet John O'Donohue wrote in praise of water. He says, "Let us bless the grace of water, the courage of a river to continue belief in the slow fall of ground, always falling farther toward the unseen ocean, keeping its appearance by insisting on disappearance, its only life surrendered to the event of pilgrimage, carrying the origin to the end. Let us bless the humility of water, always willing to take the shape of whatever otherness holds it, the innocence of water, flowing forth without thought of what awaits it. Water, vehicle and idiom of all the inner voyaging that keeps us alive."
Says, "Walking meditation should not be work. It's very pleasant, especially in the early morning when the air is still very fresh. When we walk mindfully, we see the beauty and the wonder of the earth around us, and we wake up." He says, "We see that we're living in a very wonderful moment. If our mind is caught and preoccupied with our worries and suffering, we miss these things. We can value each step we take, and each step brings us happiness. When we look again at the earth and the sky, we see that the earth is a wonderful reality." Han says, "Walk slowly, in a relaxed way. When you practice this way, your steps are those of the most secure person on the earth. Feel the gravity that makes every step attached to the earth. With each step, you're grounded on the earth." He tells us one way to practice walking meditation is to breathe in and take one step and focus all your attention on the sole of your foot. Recognize what you're doing in the current moment and say to yourself, "I am alive. I am taking a step." He suggests that it might be helpful to actually count our steps. He says, "Notice each breath and the number of steps you take as you breathe in and you breathe out. Don't try to control your breathing. Allow your lungs as much time and air as they need, and simply notice how many steps you take as your lungs fill up and how many you take as they empty. Mindful of both your breath and your steps." Han says, "Always follow the needs of your lungs. You may notice that your exhalation is longer than your inhalation. You might find that you take 3 steps during your in-breath and 4 steps during your out-breath, or 2 steps, then 3 steps. He says, if this is comfortable for you, please enjoy practicing this way. You can also try making the in-breath and the out-breath the same length, so that you take 3 steps with your in-breath and 3 with your out-breath. He says, keep walking and you'll find the natural connection between your breath and your steps. And then he adds, don't forget to practice smiling. Now, he's not talking about a great big wide smile. He's talking about what he calls a half smile, which is a very relaxed kind of smile. He says, your half smile will bring calm and delight to your steps and your breath and help sustain your attention. After practicing for half an hour or an hour, you will find that your breath, your steps, your counting, and your half smile all blend together in a marvelous balance of mindfulness. Each step grounds us in the solidity of the earth. With each step, we fully arrive in the present moment. The final video I have to share with you today is of another new place that I discovered in the past few weeks. It's not far downriver from Willow Creek Trail, and you reach it from an unmarked gravel road. I'm including the exact directions in the email. The road leads to a parking lot near a place called North Beach. If you went directly north from the parking lot, there's a wide trail that goes along the bluff over the river. There's spectacular views of the river from that trail, and it will be great in the fall and the winter, but it's not a good trail during the summer because there's no shade. The trail I'm recommending goes south from there into a beautiful stretch of the bosque, and it's as close to a quiet forest as we can get in Rio Rancho. It's an amazing trail. It goes on for miles. Once again, I found poetry to share with you that's meaningful to me. Enjoy the experience of walking in the bosque. David Wagoner wrote a poem called Lost. He said, "Stand still. The trees ahead and bushes beside you are not lost. Wherever you are is called here, and you must treat it as a powerful stranger, must ask permission to know it and be known. The forest breathes. Listen. It answers, I have made this place around you. If you leave it, you may come back again, saying, here. No two trees are the same to raven. No two branches are the same to wren. If what a tree or a bush does is lost on you, you are surely lost. Stand still. The forest knows where you are. You must let it find you." Mary Oliver wrote, "When I am among the trees, especially the willows and the honey locust, especially the beech, the oaks, and the pines, they give off such hints of gladness, I would almost say that they save me, and daily. I am so distant from the hope of myself, in which I have goodness and discernment, and never hurry through the world, but walk slowly and bow often. Around me, the trees stir in their leaves and call out, stay a while. The light flows from their branches, and they call again. It's simple, they say. And you too have come into the world to do this, to go easy, to be filled with light, and to shine." I hope hope you've enjoyed this taste today of walking as meditation. And I hope that you'll share your favorite walks with me and with each other. We're here to help and support each other and to keep our light shining. It's now time to extinguish our flaming chalice. We extinguish our chalice, but not the light that shines from within. May you walk in beauty. May you find strength and inspiration in the steps that you take each day. And may your path lead you to peace. Blessed be.